During the respiration, the glycosidic bonds of complex organic molecules are oxidized to release a lot of energy. The process included at cellular level, hence the respiration is called cellular respiration. During the cellular respiration, the glucose molecules are oxidized. It means the respiratory substrates are oxidized. Many respiratory substrates are present in both plants and animals. What are the respiratory substances? The respiratory substances are mainly three types. They are carbohydrates. Carbohydrates. Hydrates of carbons and fatty acids. It means, you see here, they are lipids. Lipids and proteins. Proteins. So these are macromolecules. Macromolecules. How the either plant body or animal body, how get the source of glucose substrate? It means the source of glucose substrate is from either photosynthesis or from its diet. For example, in the plants are synthesize their own food material. Okay, it means they are do not depend for their food. They are independent. They are autotrophs. It means they synthesize the food material themselves. It means the photosynthesis is the main source for the respiratory substances. So what is the end product released in photosynthesis? That is sucrose. So the sucrose is converted into starch. They are in the form of carbohydrates. Starch is polysaccharide. When starch get hydrolyzed, that converted into glucose, it means simpler form, the glucose is monosaccharide. Sucrose also bisaccharide. When it is hydrolyzed in the presence of invertase enzyme, it turns into two simpler monosaccharides. They are fructose and glucose. The sucrose is converted into, in the presence of invertase enzyme, into two simpler monosaccharide forms. They are glucose and fructose. The glucose is the form most suitable substrate for respiration. Okay, so the respiration is started with glucose. You see here, glucose, and that can be involved in many reaction, many successive reaction in the presence of different enzymes. Finally, it resulted into the production of energy. And another type of respiratory substances, they are lipids. Lipids are macromolecules. Okay, so the lipids are do not involve directly in the respiration. They are catalyzed into simpler form. That's why the respiration is set as catabolic reaction. Catabolic reaction means the macromolecules are turning into the simpler forms. The simpler forms are then followed into respiration. You see here, lipids. The lipids are hydrolyzed in the presence of lipase enzyme. So the lipase enzyme is produced as glycerol and fatty acids. Glycerols and fatty acids. You see here, the glycerols also, they do not enter into the respiration directly, but when they are converted into DHAP or PGAL, phosphoglyceraldehyde, then they are entered into the glycolysis. And you are coming to the fatty acids. Fatty acids also do not involve directly in the respiration. Again here they gone to oxidation. Oxidation. Due to the oxidation of fatty acids, acetyl-CoA is released. The released acetyl-CoA is entered into the Krebs cycle of respiration. Okay. You see here, it means the macromolecules, the respiratory substances, they are going to cleave into simpler form, then only they involved into the respiration. So you see here proteins. Proteins also macromolecules. Okay, in the presence of protease enzyme, they are converted into simpler forms of amino acids. These amino acids are deaminated, that are resulted to different levels of components. They are, one is pyruvic acid and acetyl CoA and alpha keto glutaric acid. So these are the compounds formed due to the deamination of amino acids. It means they become simpler forms. You see here, through the carbohydrates involved into the respiration, the glucose is the first key substrate for respiration. So glucose to fructose 6-phosphate, then fructose to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to PEP, phosphoenolpyruvic acid to pyruvic acid is produced. You see here many levels, and at fructose 6-phosphate, it means here DHAP, I told the DHAP from glycerols. So the DHAP is entered to here. It means what it indicates here, the macromolecules are converting into simpler forms. That's why the respiration is called as a catabolic reaction. But nowadays, the scientists do not agree with the respiration is a catabolic, not only catabolic reaction, it is also anabolic reaction. It is a synthetic reaction. How it is means, what are the intermediate compounds formed during the respiration? They are also involved in the synthesis of macromolecules. For example, you take acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA is the key component for the production of fatty acids. Then also it is the key component for the production of lipids too. And you take the alpha-ketoglutaric acid. The alpha-ketoglutaric acid is It provides the carbon skeleton for amino acids as well as proteins. It means they also involve the synthesis of macromolecules. That's why the anabolic reactions also carried by intermediate compounds of respiration. Okay, hence the respiration is called as amphibolic pathway. So in older days, the respiration is considered as catabolic reactions only, catabolic pathway only, but the new concept is came, that is amphibolic pathway. Amphibolic pathway means the intermediate which are resulted in the respiration, they are followed the successive reaction of the respiration for the production of ATP during the catalysis, that is one. And another one is they are also involved in the synthesis of macromolecules like lipids, fatty acids and proteins. It means they involve in the synthetic phases also. They involved in the anabolism reactions also. That's why the respiration is called amphibolic pathway.